Right. So we'll start with very quick review of yesterday's activity. We started with op-amp based active filters. Then what is filter, what is active, demonstration of the passive filter, demonstration, how active filter can overcome these, then demonstration of active filter and its advantages and so on. So we try to understand there are types like low pass filter, high pass filter, band pass, band reject. So all these circuits are actually frequency selective circuit, and such frequency selection is important because the signals will have different frequencies in it, and some of them we wish to reject or some we wish to select. For example, let me give an example. Suppose there is a sensor here and we have sensor connected to our instrumentation amplifier, and then it will go to microcontroller or any PC, any digital circuit. Suppose there is a noise of say 50 hertz because it is a power line carrier. So after the instrumentation amplifier, when the signal has gone slightly higher because we have amplified, before giving to the microcontroller, what we wish to do is we wish to add one block here. Okay, so this block is the filter, and if you want to specifically reject this 50 hertz, if you don't want to have this, then we use a specific filter called as a notch filter, which we'll understand after some time, okay, or maybe tomorrow. So filters are required so that we can reject certain unwanted signals, and we are interested only in the sensor signal. Okay, we can do filtering in microcontroller, digital filtering, but that will create complication if the signal itself is noisy. So that is why people try to maximize the sanity of the signal, it means clarity in the signal, as far as possible filter the unwanted things outside microcontroller and then get the signal and then do whatever you wish to do. So additional filtering can still be done in case of digital filtering, but analog filtering is necessary. We cannot avoid analog filtering because we live in analog world. Fine. So this is regarding the yesterday's activity. So we'll go to today's blackboard. Sorry. Today we'll go through the problems with passive filter. Now passive filter, what we understood is they are composed of only RC, for example this R and C. This is a passive filter because it uses only R and C. So it has an effect of load resistor. For example, if I connect a load, for us it may be load resistor, but this becomes part of the RC circuit and therefore the output voltage is less because of the loading. This is the first thing. Also the cutoff frequency changes because this becomes part of the RC. So this fellow is expected to consume the signal, but it is working as a part of the filter, which we do not desire. So this problem is with the RC filter, because in case of RC filter, it is not possible to isolate the load. For example, there is no isolation between the filter and the load. Right, let me cross check whether you are able to see the things properly. Okay, whether you are able to see the screens properly. Okay, good. I understand that on mobiles you do not see the cursor, is it true? Are you able to see the cursor also? Okay, 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 good. Fine. Then it's fine. So let us continue. Fine. Then the gain is always less than 1. This is but obvious because it doesn't have any amplifier, because passive filters do not have any op amp. These two are the problems primarily with the passive filter. Now, passive filters, even though we are listing problems because we are studying active filter, passive filters have their own role in certain circuits. It means we cannot throw away passive filters. Passive filters are important even though there are some problems, but in certain situations passive filters cannot be avoided. You have to use passive filter. For example, suppose I want to filter out I will write down here itself. Suppose if you want to filter out say 900 megahertz signal, okay, and if you think that you will use active filter, then you have to use op amp of 900 megahertz or almost 1 gigahertz. So such op amp will be very costly, and getting very high gain as we wish, 100,000 at 1 gigahertz is a huge bandwidth, gain bandwidth, which makes the op amp extremely costly. So the filter will be very costly. So active filters are not used. I repeat, active filters are not used for very high frequencies, because then the op amps cannot work at those frequencies. Okay, active filters have their advantages, and those advantages we wish to take in the frequency range where the op amps can work properly, typically 100 kilohertz, 1 megahertz or even less than that. So this is the range where active filters are popularly used, and passive filters are popularly used at radio frequency, radio frequencies, like higher frequencies. Because the radio frequencies are large or very high value, like 100 megahertz or 50 megahertz, 500 megahertz and so on, there the values of the inductor become small, and the smaller inductors can easily be used. So passive filters are not space consuming at such higher frequencies. Fine. So passive filters are not to be thrown away, though there are some problems. Okay, so problems with passive filter: effect of load resistor and gain always less than 1. So wherever the op amps are working properly in that frequency range, we wish to use the active filter, right. Demo of how active filter removes the problems. I think what you will do is you can, I will give an activity for you. You can do that. I think yesterday's file I will take and then show you how active filter removes the problem. So let me close this. So we have an active filter here. So let me amplify or magnify this. So you can see there is a buffer amplifier. Okay. So this buffer amplifier is sitting in between the load and the low pass filter. Okay. Thus isolating these two parts. So load cannot have any effect on the filter. Okay. So this is the advantage of using the op amp. So if you actually go to the passive filter where load is also there, there is no isolation between the load and the filter. So if you change the load, it affects the performance of the filter as such. Whereas if you go to this circuit, if you go to this circuit, there is a op amp in between. So there is no problem. So load resistor cannot affect the filter performance, because the load current is supplied not by the filter but by the op amp. Okay. So op amp is going to supply the current to the load resistor through either positive rail or negative rail, depending on the signal. If it is positive half cycle, positive rail will supply, If it is negative half cycle, negative rail will supply the current. Okay. So, this is how we say that active filter removes above problems. Effect of load resistor, it removes. Gain anyway can be higher in case of op amp, because op amp is an amplifier. We can use a op amp as an amplifier. So, you can see that we have used this as an amplifier. Okay. So, we have used this as a non-inverting amplifier with some gain. Right now, the gain is 2 because the feedback resistor are feedback resistor is 1k and the other resistor is also 1k. Right. Now, there is something called as order of filter. Order of filter. So, if you use one RC, we call it as a first order typically. If you use two RC sections, then it is used as a it is called as a second order and so on. Of course, it depends on how you connect it. If you connect two RCs in a wrong way, you cannot have second order of filter. For example, suppose this is first order filter, because we have one RC. Okay, but if somebody uses this, let me rub out this. Suppose if somebody does this, two resistors and two capacitors. If somebody says, yeah, maine to do capacitor lagaye aur do resistor bhi lagaye. So, is it a second order filter? No, it is still first order filter, because it has effectively one resistor and effectively one capacitor. I think you understood this. So, blindly do not say that one RC is one first order, two RC is second order. Broadly it is true, but not in real sense. So, we have to also see the circuit. Okay. We are going to see that. So, this is not a second order, this is still first order, even though it uses two resistors and two capacitors. It depends on the configuration. Anyway, so first order active low pass filter. First order means it uses only one R and one C. Okay, it's a low pass filter because we have used a capacitor here. Why this works as a low pass filter? Because the capacitive reactance XC reduces when frequency increases. Okay. So, when the frequency is higher and higher, capacitive reactance is lower and lower, and when it is lower, the output will be less. It means higher frequencies will be rejected. It means lower frequencies will be passed. That is why we call it as a low pass filter. Fine. Anybody having any question? Fine. So, let us move ahead. The unity gain amplifier, where whatever we have used, unity gain amplifier can be replaced by non-inverting amplifier. So, whatever gain you wish to have, you can have required gain. Okay. So, the advantage of putting an amplifier there is to isolate the load, which typically we will connect here, from the filter. This is the first primary reason. And second reason is you can get a gain. Okay. Now, third reason, if there is a place, I will just write down that. One more reason why the amplifiers will be useful or active filter will be useful is that if you have multiple stages, I think let me draw that. Suppose if we have this filter, then we want to have one more similar filter, we want to still filter it, we want to have one more similar filter, and then we want to connect them. Okay. So this is first order, this is second order, this is third order. Okay. Likewise, what is its effect on the output, we'll see. But if we actually connect it this way, then this particular part works as a load resistor to this fellow, causing some loading on the first part of the filter. This part works as loading on this. So every next stage works as a load resistor or load impedance on the earlier stages, thereby disturbing the operation of earlier circuits. So this particular thing is not desirable, even though sometimes we may use for saving the cost, but this is not good way of doing it. So what should be done is, I'll undo this. What should be done is this actually. So what should be done is, we should use a buffer amplifier in between. I'm drawing a small circuit and inverting, non-inverting is now understood. I need not draw it every time. Okay. So if you use buffer amplifiers in between unity gain amplifiers, there is no effect of the next stage on the earlier stage. So thereby each filter is working properly independently, but the signal of one filter is passed to the other filter as input to the next stage. So the each stage, stage 1, stage 2, stage 3, they are working without any problem. Okay. So this is the advantage of putting an amplifier here. So what is the advantage? Isolation of each stage is the advantage of active filter, putting an op amp in the filter. This is the advantage. Fine. Now what we understood is that, let me draw and then start explaining. We are thinking of low pass filter. Let us draw the characteristics of low pass filter. Log F and then gain in decibels. Okay. About log F, read on various websites like why we use log F and why we use dB. And in case you have a question, you specifically ask that question during the question and answer. Okay. So in case of low pass filter, the low frequencies are passed, the gain is constant, and then the gain falls. Then the gain falls at nearly constant rate. Okay. So this is the gain characteristics. This is gain characteristics. It means gain is changing with respect to frequency. Now, not only the gain is changing, the phase is also changing. Now, we wish to understand how the phase is changing and what effect does it have on the filter. So, for that we will go to simulator and then go to first order and active filter. It means we target only V out 2, okay. And the input, what is the input? Input is VG1, we can see VG1 is the input, fine. Even though there are three circuits in this full sheet, let me show you which are the three circuits. Okay. First one is the RC passive circuit, the load is connected. Okay. We are not interested in this now. Then second circuit is RC filter, RC low pass filter with op amp with unity gain, and the third is RC filter, low pass filter with gain, some gain of 2. These are the three circuits out of which we will see this part. So what we wish to see is effect of the phase difference between input and output, right. Now to plot the phase response, we will again go to analysis and then do AC analysis and then AC transfer characteristics. Okay. then I will check I'm setting 10 hertz to say 11 kilohertz, and I am interested. Usually this phase will be unticked, it won't be selected, but sorry, you will select this phase and click OK. Okay, and then the gain will be shown and the phase also will be shown. Okay. Now, there are two graphs, or in fact three graphs, which we will take out some of the graphs by isolating separate outputs and V out, let me remove this also, let me remove. Okay, I am selecting that and pressing delete. So, this is the gain characteristics. Okay. Now, let me show you first of all what we discussed yesterday. Anyway, I will write down that once again. So, the gain falls at the rate minus 20 dB per decade. Decade means 10 times the frequency. Decade means, so if you start the frequency say at 1 kilohertz, then 1 into 10, 1 kilohertz to 10 kilohertz is 1 decade. If you start it at 2, then 2 times 10, that is 20, to 2 to 20 is 1 decade, like that. So, let us check whether it is really 20 dB per decade. So, for that we will go to cursor and select one region which is nearly linear here, and maybe we will stop here and check what is the y value. Okay. So, y value is dB minus 11 dB, fine. Y value is minus 11 dB, and instead of 550, what I'll do is I'll take it as 500. Okay, 500. Now, what is 10 times 500? 5000. Okay, so now I will type 5000. Now, as soon as I type 5000, watch this particular value. Okay, this value will change, and we have to check by what amount it will change. So, let me type 5000. 5000 means I am increasing it 10 times. It means I am jumping by 1 decade. Okay, let me type 5000. We are jumping by how much? 1 decade. And the y value, that is gain, will jump by something. I am pressing enter now. Okay. Now, it has gone to minus 29.95, that is 30. So, what was its value earlier? It was, so this was 500 and it was minus 10. Now, it has gone to minus 30. So, minus 10 to minus 30, that is how many dBs change? 20 dBs. So, that is why, and it went down actually. Okay. So, therefore, we call it as a 20 dB per decade. Now, this is true for any range. For example, suppose if I select instead of 500, now I select 700, okay, press enter, 13 dB, 13 dB is the starting. Now, I changed it to 7000, 10 times jump. So, the dB will change from minus 13 and it will reduce by 20 dB. So, it should go to 33 dB, minus 33. Okay, it has gone to minus 32.87. So, almost minus 33. Fine. So, therefore, we say that the gain of the low pass filter, first order low pass filter, reduces by 20 dB per decade, that is the rate is minus 20 dB per decade. Now, this rate is in the stop band. Now, what is stop band? Stop band means the area where the gain is falling. So, this is the stop band. This is the stop band. This is the stop band. Maybe I will show you by different, this is the stop band, because the gain is falling. So, in the stop band, it is falling by minus 20 dB per decade, and this is called as a, this is called as a pass band, okay. This is the pass band. I will use white pen, that is better, pass band. This is pass band because the gain is constant, right. So, what did we understand and what did we saw? We saw that in case of first order filter, the gain falls at minus 20 dB per decade. Fine. Any question? If there is any question, you will enable the mic, your own mic. You can left swipe, I think right swipe. Then there will be speak button, you can ask question. I will repeat the question for the advantage of all of you, so that everybody will be able to listen the question, and then I will answer. Anyway, so let me have a small chat. Right, the time is almost up, half an hour is almost up, but anyway, okay, good. So, I will show you within 10 minutes the second order low pass filter. After this time, because the meeting has a timeout, because we are using free version, I will have to set up one more meeting. So, we will set up one more meeting after say 15 minutes of break, and then we will rejoin, and I will set the new meeting, and then we will start with the second order filter. But anyway, whatever time we have, 10 minutes, we will use that time for second order active low pass filter, okay. Now, this is the circuit of second order active low pass filter. Now, actually the second order filter would have been like this, second order means 2 RC. So, first RC and second RC. This is the second order. And then we would have connected an op amp, okay. But the issue is here. What is the issue? The issue is that this particular fellow is going to work as a load of this particular fellow, okay, which is not at all desired, okay. We do not want that. So, that is why this circuit is not considered as a second order active filter, even though op amp is there. This should be very clear. This is a second, looks like a second order filter, looks like op amp is there, but it is not second order active filter, because this is how we should not use, because then there is no advantage of op amp. There is a loading of second stage on the first stage. So, this is not to be used. So, let me rub out. So, this is not the way in which second order filter is designed. Second order filter standard circuit is this, okay. This is the standard circuit. So, first R and C, C is having a feedback. So, this circuit, this particular part is not loading the earlier part, because there is facility of current from the output of the op amp. So, there is no loading as such. The derivation of this circuit is complicated. So, we are deferring right now for that. We will directly go to demonstration. By that, we will understand how the things happen, and then if time allows, we can go through the derivation. Okay. So what we will do is we will quickly go through the simulation. So I think we did not do the time part, but anyway we will do that. So let us keep an eye on the time. So the time is up, so we will take a pause, and it is 10:38 now, and we will join by 11 a.m. Let me check whether everybody is okay with 11 a.m. Good. So take a break, and in the next session I will show you a demo of second order filter. Okay. We will also see how the phase behavior through simulation again, so that many times phase bola to sab confuse ho jate. So we will keep try to understand that in its right way. So see you at what time? 11 a.m. okay. Bye.